As the Earth warms, sea levels are rising, and superstorms are becoming more frequent and intense. Many of the world's major coastal cities may soon be underwater. In the last 5 years alone, the United States has been hit with 83 hurricanes, devastating cities from New York to Houston. Now, WNET's Peril and Promise initiative presents a new four-part documentary series, Sinking Cities, which explores how four global cities are coming to grips with the real-time effects of climate change. We have your preview.
New York's population is at its highest in history and shows no sign of declining. 8.6 million people now call the five boroughs home, and that population has risen 5.5% since 2010, leading the state in population growth.
I have looked at the evolution of New York City over its 400 years of existence. It has undergone so many mutations. I mean, it did not look anything like it looks now. Why should it look in 100 years anything like it looks now?
Clues to the future challenges New York City faces may be found in its past, in urban development that started over 300 years ago.
I remember getting a call from Bill not all that long after Hurricane Sandy, and he asked if we have maps which show in a really dramatic fashion how the landfill in New York City had an impact on the severity of the storm.
My name is Bill Johnson. In 2012, I was director of the statewide mapping program, part of the Division of Homeland Security and Emergency Services. They were hoping that the maps would help them understand the underlying issues related to the storm. And so we started thinking about how we could help her with this work.
My reaction to this kind of request was excitement in that we had means to contribute to helping the city become a more resilient place.
We started thinking about overlays of aerial imagery with historic maps.
We had all of these maps here in digital format already, and we had them stretched over the same geographic grid so that they lined up when we compare them.
Those were the raw ingredients we needed. We had an accurate representation of everything that had changed between 1609 and 2012, as evidenced in an aerial photo. So when we overlay this 1860 map on the 1767, what's immediately apparent is that there's a tremendous expansion. Here's the 1767 shoreline I'm tracing with my finger. So all of this from here out to here is new. We overlay that on the modern map of Manhattan, and you can see how much of Lower Manhattan is actually constructed on the man-made reclaimed land.
An area which was formerly undeveloped is the scene of a project in which employment is provided for both skilled and unskilled workers. A long bulkhead was built to reclaim land from the waters of the bay.
Almost 4 square miles of modern-day Manhattan is built on landfill, added all along the city's coasts.
We took the Sandy storm surge data and overlaid it on top to see if there was alignment between the man-made lands and where the flooding occurred from Sandy. And what we can see is that it very dramatically aligns with the man-made area. What this really reveals is that the flooding from Superstorm Sandy is largely man-made. The flooding occurred largely as a result of 400 years of human activity that basically created a new floodplain. And that floodplain is densely filled with modern urban infrastructure, subway tunnels, power plants, and that's where we saw the damage from flooding from Sandy.
The reclaimed land Johnson identifies is a critical part of the U.S. economy. Banking, finance, technology, communication, insurance. More Fortune 500 companies have offices here than anywhere else on the planet.
We are the financial capital of the country, if not the world. We are the center of arts and media. Many of the media companies for this country, if not the world, are headquartered here. We have to get it right because of what we mean to the economy of the country and the economy of the world. We need to do better.